Like to inform the House that they are still there.
On 16th November 2016, Okino Jara, the Member of Parliament for Chwa West in Chitugum District, asked the Speaker of Parliament to task the Executive to explain Uganda's position on membership to the International Criminal Court.
What is our stand in regard to either remaining as members of the ICC or exiting from the ICC?
Can you be specific? You don't need to be circumlocutious. Just tell this Parliament whether we are interested in being part of the ICC or we are not.
Kitgum and other districts in northern Uganda suffered terrible effects, including loss of thousands of lives over the 2 decades of the RRA war. Command of the RRA rebels Joseph Kony and some of his colleagues have been indicted by the ICC and faced trial in the Hague-based court. President Yoweri Museveni has on many public occasions locally and abroad spoken out strongly against the ICC, saying the World Court had been hijacked by forces hell-bent on prosecuting African leaders. He argued that many other people in Europe and elsewhere had committed crimes within the ICC's jurisdiction but had gone scot-free.
Omusajja n'ova mu nyumba yo n'ogenda mu nyumba y'omuntu omulala tikola bw'oti kola bw'oti oba musiru wa kika ki.
In May 2016 and before, the ICC took issue with Uganda when President Yoweri Museveni invited Sudanese President Omar el-Bashir to his swearing-in ceremony in Kololo, Kampala. The ICC wondered why Uganda did not arrest Bashir and handed him over to the court that can only enforce its orders through member states. Bashir is wanted for trials at the ICC for alleged war crimes in Darfur.
As members of ICC,
in Parliament, the Attorney General William Byaruhanga informed the House that Uganda has no intention of withdrawing from the Rome Statute that created the ICC in 2002.
The government of Uganda had not and has not notified any person or organization that it was or is withdrawing from the Rome Statute. Accordingly, the apprehension that we are withdrawing for the Rome Statute, both within Uganda and abroad, is based on conjecture.
He explained that Uganda would implement the decision of the African Union if members choose to withdraw from court en masse. The AU had previously resolved not to cooperate with the court. African countries form the bulk of the ICC members.
While Uganda shall continue to be part of the ICC and to cooperate with it, it shall not hesitate to abide by any position reached by the African Union in pursuit of peace and stability on the continent.
But MPs across the political divide warned against the decision to withdraw from the court without wide consultation.
I therefore, Right Honourable Speaker, request the Attorney General to come out, let Ugandans know whether we dance on the tunes of African Union, whether we dance on the tunes of ISIS.
We can't say here that because there is ISIS, that's how Africa will guarantee the security. If Ugandans can't guarantee their security, and they say they run to ICC, we are lost. Thank you. Are we remaining firmly as members of ICC, looking at the historic connection between ICC and Uganda, or what? So you better be clear and tell this country.
Others advised the president against publicly lambasting the court.
We want to advise our president not to talk too much against the ICC. Let him tone down so that as a country.
The president is saying ICC is bad, and ICC is embedded in the laws of this country, and we are sticking to the Rome Charter. That's where the debate is.
Uganda was the first country to refer a case, the RRA situation, to the ICC in 2003. The RRA leader Joseph Kony and other RRA commanders faced charges of war crimes and crimes against humanity before the court.
Not me, or that is not my paper.
Herbert Ziwa, NTV at Parliament.